City and state leaders will be hosting a day-long public discussion tomorrow in Eureka Springs to talk about a plan to build nearly 50 miles of electrical transmission lines through the Ozarks. 4029's Emily Maha spoke with community members to find out how they feel about this controversial plan. She's live tonight.
Ben, I'm here tonight at Inspiration Point, just off Highway 62 in Eureka Springs, and it's right behind me where Southwestern Electric Power Company, or SWEPCO, hopes to build those new transmission lines. Now, I spoke with community members and business owners who tell me those transmission lines could ruin the local economy.
I think they'll be very destructive to this area, especially right in here where we are a totally tourism-based economy.
Wanda Kersman owns Castle Antiques in Eureka Springs. She says the transmission lines would have a negative effect on tourism in the area.
There are several businesses that will be impacted directly if the line comes through. If you can imagine taking a canoe ride, a float, or fishing on the White River with that power line running beside you for close to 2 miles and then crossing under it, you know that will impact it.
Kurtzman is not alone. All of the people I spoke with today are against SWEPCO's plan to build the transmission lines.
We moved here basically 2 years ago, built this house. We've fallen in love with the area. It's beautiful. We love Eureka Springs, and Eureka Springs is based on tourism.
Lynn Eaton will be speaking at tomorrow's public hearing. She hopes the Arkansas Public Service Commission understands how vital tourism is to this area.
We like the people around here. They're wonderful people. We don't want to see their homes devalued, and we don't want to see the recreational opportunities diminished, and we don't want to see the tourism dollars go away. I mean, that's the basis of the economy here.
Under the direction of the federal government, SWEPCO has been requested to build the 345,000-volt transmission line that will run through Benton County into Carroll County. The transmission line would provide power to Carroll County, but for this community, it is a plan unwelcome.
We know lots of people who have businesses here, and this will hurt them. And we want to stand in solidarity with our friends and neighbors.
There are 6 different routes for the proposed transmission line, but tomorrow's public hearing will focus on just one. Live in Eureka Springs, Emily Maha, 4029 News.
Certainly a controversial plan. Emily, thanks. Tomorrow's public hearing will be held at the Inn of the Ozarks Convention Center. The first public discussion starts at 9 a.m. and the last one wraps up at 9 p.m.